I created a Git repository that has a 69-step build and deploy process. Why? Because you can. And in today's video, I'm going to show you the entire process. And it starts with the essentials all the way to utter nonsense. Let's go. So when you're working on a software project, you always end up with a Git repository of some sort. However, in between you developing features or fixing bugs and users using your app, there's a whole lot of work that needs to be done for your code in the middle. And this can include things like compiling the code to begin with, making sure that the tests pass in your code, committing to other repositories if it's connected, etc. And these jobs also need to be run on different conditions within your Git repository. So things like when a dev submits a pull request, when the code is merged into the main branch, when a new branch is created. And this is where the CI/CD pipeline comes in. They're customizable in many ways and are flexible to whatever your project requires. And thanks to today's sponsor, GitLab, I'll be wasting their computer resources today. So to make this video somewhat educational, I'll clone this repository called Open Contracts, which is a free open source document analytics tool built in Python and JavaScript. It's just for an example, I don't even know how this software works. Now that we have a full functional project, let the fun begin. So here's the first things that we're going to add into our pipeline. Linting and tests. So I'm just gonna open up my IDE and create a YAML file. I will use GitLab Duo Chat, which integrates in easily with whatever IDE you use and can understand your project. So for making CI/CD pipelines, this is great. Now, the way that the Open Contracts is built is actually quite interesting. It's a big repository with all the separated pieces in one repository. So we have to do some digging around on how we can get every part of the project covered. Any sane developer would split this up into different pipelines, because if you have front-end changes, you don't wanna mess around with the stuff on your back end. But today we won't be taking that advice because it's my video and I don't want to. So here's a list of all the items. For the front end, here we go. Prettify all JavaScript files, lint all JavaScript files, and then test all the JavaScript files. And after implementation, this gives us a total of about 6 steps and we just lightly touch the front end. Now, the reason you would do this is because it unifies a central style so that when people contribute code, it will all have the same layout and format. And so after I run this pipeline, about 3.5 minutes for about 250 files or so, which, you know, it's not bad. We also basically run the same command twice to validate if it's, you know, formatted correctly, which is so stupid, but that's the point of the video. One formats it on the spot and one checks it after. Next, we gotta go through our backend. This application is really, really backend heavy, so we gotta be ramping this up a bit. The backend is built using Django, a Python web framework. I actually have some experience with this, but not at this scale of a project. So first, the linter. Let's go set up Python 3.10 and pip install all the requirements needed. Now, what's cool for this project, they implemented something called pre-commit, which is a framework for running scripts before, after, or during a Git commit. It's like we have many systems fighting over each other. It's insane. We will implement what the repository already implements, 5 different linting procedures: whitespace trimming, upgrading Python, black formatter, isort to sort imports, flake 8 to format code. And testing the code is a whole separate process. Since this is a Django application, there's a lot of steps needed to get this up and running. Setting up the right Docker environment to simulate production, we need these tags: vector embedder, Django, Postgres, Redis, Celery. Once that is set up, we then migrate the database to have the correct columns and tables, collect static files, test the Docker containers, inspect the overlying network, grab the logs, create a coverage file. This lets us know how much of our code has been covered in testing. Tear everything down so that we don't get charged $1 million. And so that means that we went from 6 steps to 19 steps. I mean, that's a lot, but we've only linted and tested our code. We haven't even done anything decent yet. So with everything happening one after the other, nothing happening in sequence, we get about 8.5 minutes where, you know, the testing took up a majority of the time. So go figure. Okay, this is fun, like, you know, learning practical information, but let's get a little bit silly. Mm-hmm. First, we're going to add a Discord and Slack integration for each significant stage. That way we can annoy everybody about when something is working or if something is failing. And currently we have four essential steps: lint frontend, lint backend, test frontend, test backend. Now, rather than a simple status, which no one will read, like no one reads that, let's give people incentive to understand how things are going. We will give each of these stage personalities that will go through a large language model and output something funny, but related to the status. So with Grok and Llama 3.21b, it will generate something good in like 32 milliseconds. So pretty good. Then we'll just output that both to Slack and Discord. Also, since we're 10x developers, we don't have time to review the merge requests that just aren't significant. So we'll also create a step that determines if the title is funny enough in order to accept. Also, never deploy on Fridays. So let's add a step that automatically fails the entire pipeline if it is a Friday. Let's also add an integration to randomly choose a song based on how well the merge request is. That way it can be suspenseful or happy. That means we went from 19 steps all the way to 35 steps. And like, I love how half of our steps is making sure that users do not contribute to this repository. I've been using GitLab Duo throughout this video, who is also the sponsor of today's video. GitLab Duo is a suite of AI tools that integrates into your Git repositories and IDEs while understanding your project that you're working on. It uses Claude 3.5 Sonnet and Vertex Search to power its code completions for you. And working in this CI/CD pipeline project that I'm doing has been extremely easy for me to add things or debug why something didn't work in the log using the Duo root cause analysis feature. If you're interested in improving your developer productivity, make sure you give GitLab Duo a try. Make sure you use the link below, and that will help support the channel. Thank you. Now, of course, we have to deploy this big boy. Surprisingly, this won't be that hard. The infrastructure is already pretty easy to understand considering the Docker Compose files. It gives us an understanding of what technology is needed to run this entire operation. Since we have a front end and a back end, we'll need two entirely separate processes. First, the front end will be fairly simple. We just have to add a couple steps. Run the optimized build process. And this is usually the only thing that we have to run. Transfer over to our cloud provider, flip the on switch, have our AI bot say something random, and then distribute it to Slack and Discord. Perfect. But for our backend, we have to take every single little part that this backend infrastructure relies on and deploy it separately to the cloud. Let's create some Terraform configuration files. I have some videos and shorts that talk about infrastructure as code, but essentially the way it works is that you can write configuration files and it can deploy and destroy infrastructure on the fly instead of using the web-based interfaces. So this whole entire thing can actually be done in one step. Manage Postgres, VM for Django, managed Redis, managed queuing service, object storage. And then we'll just deploy to four separate clouds because, you know, why choose one when you could just do a bunch? So this overly engineered solution is crazy. From 35 steps to 52. God, are you kidding me? I think we can sprinkle a little bit more on top. Because we can, custom ASCII art representation of the project logo for each build. Implement a random 15% chance of automatically denying a pull request. Create automatic documentation. Replace all words of that documentation with gibberish. Deploy the documentation. Implement a security scan. If nothing critical, then fail because we want people to have a challenge. Add performance benchmarking tests to compare against previous versions. Create an automated changelog generator based on commit messages and pull request descriptions. Add a 1% chance after each phase that could cause everything to fail. And this brings our total steps to an impressive 69 steps. Jeez. Each one adding a layer of complexity and absurdity to our already engineered pipeline. At this point, we've transformed a simple CI/CD process into a cursed monstrosity that some people will claim is software engineering. Thanks to GitLab for being today's sponsor. You can give GitLab Duo a try in any of the code editors of your choice. What would you add to this pipeline if you could? Let me know in the comments below.